Hey folks, let's play a round of Runers, shall we? This is a game made by Let's Get Kraken and published by Mastertronic Limited. This game is something that I've been playing around with for a few weeks since it came out this early September, and hopefully I'm not terrible at the game anymore, which means I'll be able to show you what it's like, because I personally quite enjoy it. It's a game in a sort of similar vein to The Binding of Isaac, whereupon you proceed to different floors and power up and fight progressively harder monsters using projectile attacks, not necessarily projectile attacks in this game, with permadeath as well. When you die, that's it, you have to start again on the adventure mode. The main difference in this game is the runes, hence the name Runers. To learn new abilities, you have to combine runes using rune combiners in a sort of experimental magic discovering process. As you can see, I played it a bit. I have 85 spells, but still 200 that I don't know. That's a lot of spells. There are three kinds of spells, levels rather, but I will show you that as we go in. Let's play an adventure, shall we? There's Wimpy and Regular, and I've not got very far on Regular, and I've not even played Wimpy. Let's play Regular. Another difference to Binding of Isaac here is you can select your race and your class. Each race has a slight blurb and an ability, and each class has a blurb and an actual hero ability that can be used. This is more of a passive ability here. Humans are your box standard, get +5% to all stats. Elves have better runes but are negative to stats, and The orcs here, their damage is increased for the more damage they take. Golems have more armor, etc., etc. I have a few favorites that I quite like, but every single class will suit different race will suit different playstyles, and will suit different kinds of spells. And the same goes with the classes. Each of them has a class ability that will suit different types of playstyle and different kinds of spell loadouts. For me personally, I have a few favorites when it comes to races. Dwarf being one of my favourites. Their damage increases by +40% when they're near an enemy, but it can go up to -70% when they're far away, which means you don't want to be firing spells from a far range. Other ones that I like are the Shade, which is always firing random projectiles everywhere. I like the Elf too, -2% to all stats, that's a negative, but +2 to all rune levels means that all of your runes are, you have the potential to go higher with your runes. So I think I'm actually going to play an elf. And as for races, they have a, every single source of damage is reflected back to caster, blocks all damage for 4 seconds. Personally, I like the cultist of Prevnik here, who slows all enemies and increases their cooldowns on their casting. I also like the Deific Assassin for the ability for your next attack to automatically critical. And I also quite like the Corpse Creeper. Demonic Warlock is a bit interesting, but for me, I think we're going to play an Elven Assassin. And the final choice you get to pick on character generation is your first spell. This is a one-room spell. You start the game knowing how to make all of these, and each one has different abilities. Kindle has a damage over time, deals half its damage immediately and half as a dot. Droplet, I believe, has some knock... I think it's like area effect, I think? Earth Spike is an instant appearance of the damage, and it's quite high, it doesn't travel. Airwave has high knockback. Spark fires really fast. Spark has a short cooldown. Kinetic Bolt fires fast. Mind Spike pierces enemies. Magic Missile reduces the cooldown of your other spells when you cast it. Corruption slows down the enemy when they're hit. And Chaos Bolt is high damaging, but completely erratic in where it fires, and I'm not picking that. Instead, we're either going to go with Kinetic Bolt or we're going to go with Spark. And personally, I think we're going to go with Spark. Actually, we're going to go with a Cultist and Spark. Why? I'll tell you why. Go to floor one. There's a little bit of a story here. I feel her, deep beneath the ground. She calls to me, and I feel my shame. Why? Because you look like an evil caster of dark magics. and you can fire lightning. As you can see, my ability is on a 61.2 second cooldown. If I press Q, it activates. I only have one spell right now. Spark has a very short cooldown, but a very, very, very long range and moderate damage. In fact, it has 2.45 damage. You can see by the range icon, there is a rune symbol for lightning. That means that if I increase the ability of this spell by putting more shock runes in there, it will only increase the range. It will not increase the damage. So this is not a high damaging spell. But fortunately, it's a fast spell, which would have combined with my assassin ability. But I'm not an assassin, I'm a cultist. So let's go on. This is the first area. The floor here has all three exits and the room, an event. Auras, like that one there, for the next room, will change the buff or debuff for a zone, a room. Like, it could make your runic level for spells lower, it could make your, could buff you, make you more susceptible to knockbacks. These are various scenery items. You can hide behind them, and you can also just shoot them, which I'm going to do to look for items and find none. Let's not go in there right now, and instead let's go up. There might be enemies, there might just be items. There are in fact enemies! You can see the rats there that are easy to kill. The digging, burrowing creatures that I always forget the name of that will try and ram into you and will attempt to bite you. And two wizard types. The lightning wizard here, the shock wizard, is firing the same kind of spell I am, but a lot slower than me. The Earth Wizard here is using the Earth Spike spell in an attempt to harm me. But as long as you keep moving, I should be relatively alright. Much like Binding of Isaac, being stationary is not a good is not a good decision generally. You want to keep moving. Oh, and there is a shock rune. We only have one rune though, so if we wanted to, we could increase the range of our spell. I don't feel like I want to just yet. Last one. You have to kill all enemies in a room to leave, and there is some health. Some races get, one race, I think the Wisp gets lowered health gains from those, but they get another benefit, like every single rune they get has various buffs. This one, for instance, has no buff. It could say, like, plus 5% damage or plus 5% cooldown reduction, which means that, or minus 5% cooldown reduction, which means that if I were to make a spell using that, that spell would intrinsically have those buffs. This room has no actual monsters in it at all. Also, I like the music. Pretty atmospheric. Definitely sets the tone. I'll get into the rune crafting when we actually get a large quantity of runes, because I know all the level 2 spells right now. Oh, Entropy Wizards! I dislike Entropy Wizards! In fact, these are the worst two wizards in the game for me. Entropy Wizards and Kinetic Wizards. Kinetic Wizards attacks are really fast, and Entropy Wizards fire really quickly with a strong attack that's completely erratic. Unlike the other ones, the other wizards, who are pretty predictable in where they'll fire, Entropy Wizards can fire anywhere. You can see here, this is a portal. This portal will give a random buff to one of the monsters in that aura. We don't want them to have that, so we destroyed it. Another shock rune. If I wanted, I could make a spell out of this. I could combine these two runes, and I know what spell it is. It's Chain Lightning, which I'm not a fan of, personally. It's it hits, and then it hits an area around it. If I didn't have that spell known, I'd need something called a double combiner to create it, and it would just say question mark here. I wouldn't know what it is. Fortunately, when you learn it, or the fact that I know it, means that forevermore, you will actually know what that spell is. It will be in your rune decks. So I could then look up exactly what the spell does, and I'll know what the spell does when I'm trying to cast, trying to make it. This here is an event room. This is going to be a difficult event, isn't it? Yes, it is a protect mission. Help is needed for those less powerful, and aid is to be provided. Let's protect the helpless one. I'm going to suck royally at this, but there's a second event over there. Let's try, though. This guy needs protecting. He does have spells of his own. However, the enemies are going to go for him. And as such, we need to protect him. If you protect him, you manage to save him, he will give you a buff in the form of a protective piece of equipment. Like a rune or a spell or... Oh, we're gonna do it! Yeah! Oh! Did we fail? What happened here? What? Oh! I don't know if we succeeded or failed there! He died at the same time as the enemy. We got a load of experience, so perhaps we did succeed. We're going to find out in a moment. That's the first time it's ever happened to me. Right, so, we leveled up. We get to select a trait. These are random. You get a choice of four completely random traits. Reduce the effect of room auras. Sacrifice all your traits to stave off death. No, not personally. Tinkerer means you get more experience for shattering double containers. I like this one, Gravity Collapse. A 10% chance to cause a force on enemies in a radius around it when an enemy is killed. Pretty much it drags enemies to that position. I like this one. We did technically complete it, because we actually got the escort event completed. He died, but we got it. Right. We have a choice of an Entropy Rune, a Crit Defense Rune, a Shock Rune, or an Air Rune. I'm going with an Entropy Rune, because there's a very funny combination of spell here. It's called Double Lightning, Shock and Entropy. It fires all over the place. What it's not showing you there is the cooldown is 0.2 of a second, and the Shock Rune this time increases the damage. The Entropy Rune reduces the arc. Switching a spell out on any of these slots, the left and right and the 1 and 2 buttons, has a 5 second cooldown. Look at that. Now look at this. Now I have lightning. That is absurd. It's not long range, but it will do for now. This is a stasis. Can you win with your powers reduced? Activating the stasis event will unleash the enemies and curse you with a reduction in all rune levels. Go for it! My runes are not as powerful, but that doesn't matter because I fire entropic lightning everywhere! Death to those who do not respect the lightning! I won! I get a choice of an earth rune, dark rune, bullet size, or what I'm going to pick, 5% bonus damage permanently. That's really going to help my damage output. Let's go to the next room, shall we? Let's curse these enemies with reduced movement and cooldowns. You are nothing compared to my lightning power. So much so that I've leveled again. Have knowledge of rooms? It's not seeing, it's knowing. Nah. No, I like the idea of the movement speed. We're going with it. Movement speed is important. If you move fast, that means you're going to avoid enemies better. And there is one boss, the one, like, area one boss that I've not completed. Their movement would really be nice. Right, let's go to the next room. Ooh, dark wizards! And mind wizards, too. There are a few good spells I really like, but I'm not going to show off all the spells. Mainly because half of the fun is actually discovering the spells yourself. You'll find spells that really, really work. You'll also find spells that really, really don't, and I'm going to warn you about one spell. Actually, no, I didn't find it. I decided not to show you the page there, because otherwise you'd have seen all those runes, but it's called Wibbly Woo, and you do not want Wibbly Woo. I don't like Wibbly Woo, personally. Some people, it might be for your taste, but if you find Wibbly Woo, tell me what you think, because I found it worthless. For me, there are some spells that just don't suit my playstyle at all. There are probably some spells that don't suit anyone's playstyle, but there are nearly 300 spells. You'll eventually find one that's useful for you. These are big bugs. Bugs like homing in on you, by the way. If they see you, they'll just beeline to you. Otherwise, they stick to walls and other surfaces, and tend not to do very much. Quite harmless if you leave them to their own devices. Down we go. I do not want these people to go fast, especially not the kinetic wizards there. As you can see, with a combination of two spells, you can pretty much destroy the first floor of the game quite well. If you go to the second floor without having a second spell that's quite decent, you will end up in some serious bother. Your first playthroughs will be you desperately trying to find new spells and figuring out what they do and finding one that works. I found a few that worked really well, that got me quite far, but it took a while for me to actually defeat a boss. Also, look at me go! Like I'm constantly on ice! Down we go to the next area. Oh no, bats! This is where having lightning spell, double lightning, really is good. Bats are extremely fast, they fly randomly, and they will sort of semi-home in on you. Bats are annoying. If you don't have an area effect ability against bats, you're in trouble. Area effect's actually pretty good in this game, but also long range is pretty good. If I meet the you saw the zombies earlier? The zombies move faster if they get close to you. There are cleaver throwing zombies, who literally will throw cleavers at you. Also, the reason why I have two aiming icons here is because of that weird brain-like monster down there that throws off your aim. Fortunately, when you're firing as erratically as my character is, you have absolutely no need to aim. Oh no! Oh, that was bad. Did you see all my health go? It's because of that darn hermit! Hermits increase the damage of all rodents. And I just went from having loads of health to having no health. That is something I have found sometimes. You'll go into a room and you'll just be immediately pinned in and get completely destroyed because you can't move. It's a rarity. And when you get to the triple spells, which is what I'm making, where you have to put three spells in here and get a triple combiner, which you can either find rarely off monsters in later levels or combining four double combiners, you'll end up, the spell progression is now really slow. Anyway, going to the next floor gives me the choice of some runes. I could take a mind rune, 8% knockback, 10% crit, or what I'm actually going to take, 5% more damage. I remember little of the night I lost her. The sound of distant water, the smell of smoke, and a crushing sense of panic. I haven't got far enough in the game to really know what's going on with that story. But it does make me curious to find out. I think I looked floor 5 as the furthest I've ever got. Right, let's go. There are no thieves on this floor. Oh, there's one! Those thieves are annoying, and as you saw there, he was beelining towards that rune. He beelined towards it because he wanted to steal it. See there? My damage there increased to 10.66 because I put a shock rune in. Yeah, they try and steal drops and teleport away. They basically want to steal your buffs, and if you let them, they will do so. Also, these are wizards who have mastered both fire and water and are using a spell that, if you think about it, it makes sense as to what they're casting, and you can make it yourself. Like, the game does give you hints to spells, like those are imps, they're using a fire spell. Perhaps you can make that spell if you combine fire runes. And you're quite right. That spell can be made with some combination of fire rune. The game, however, is throwing entropy and shock runes at me. The entropy rune there reduced the arc of the lightning's damage slightly, which means it's a little less erratic. So far, I'm having... Oh, these are skeletons. And a hermit. Hermit dies right now. The yellow aura, by the way, denotes a champion monster, which is actually stronger than a normal one. Also, that skeleton there that fell, did you see it? It got back up? That's because I didn't walk over its corpse to destroy it. Skeletons will get back up. There are also another monster, an ent, which turn into trees when destroyed, and if you destroy the tree, they come back as ents. I've leveled up again. Let's have a look. When you're near destructible, nope, don't like that one. Whenever you have a status effect, no. After killing, on pickup of item, lower your cooldowns. They're all pretty rubbish, actually. I think, to be honest, I'm going to pick the status effect one. I also got another double combiner. I now have two of them. You can combine three of them to create... Four of them, sorry, to create a triple one. Or you can just smash it for 50 experience. I'm still in the process of discovering spells, so I'm not going to break it. Oh, monsters right off the go! That was a bad thing. Also, that was a boss thief. Those guys are fast, by the way, but the little losers there periodically stop to, consider, recollect their thoughts. But overall, as you can see, I am learning about the game. You do figure out things as you go, like in Binding of Isaac, and you do get better at it. I was awful at this game at the beginning. I was really bad. Also, these thieves are now firing arrows at me, and he stole that. He was then going to run away and try and escape the level. Once he is teleported away, he is gone forever. You never see that thief again. You'll see other thieves, but not that one. That one will have got away with your prized possession. We also have now a lot more runes. Water runes, some light runes. There you are. See, there's one. Plus 5% bullet duration. Plus 5% bullet size. I make runes with those. Spells with those, and those spells will have those buffs. Make sure to pick a spell that actually, if you know that is, if you know the spell, make sure to pick one that actually has, for instance, bullets. Don't put a bullet duration one on something with no bullets unless you absolutely have to. I've not got far enough yet into the game to learn the deep nuances, but I think I'm getting there. Also, my health is okay. I prefer it to be bigger. Oh! No! Zombies! Let's destroy them now while we can. Phase Wizard, you see that thief just beeline for him and gotta go get that rune! And then he died. They're just throwing lightning runes and shock and entropy runes at me. They really want me to demo this arc lightning. Well, oh! You see that root thing there? Those are, spawners for the rats. It will spawn an infinite number of rats over time if you let it. I am not going to let it. And another entropy rune! Jeez! I don't think I've ever had this many entropy runes this early in the game. The arc's actually pretty narrow now. So I just love the fact that it's just lightning everywhere. I would actually like to replace that spell. But at the moment, I don't have a lot to replace it with. Oh! There's an upgrade to that now. You know the purple one there? It fires out a corrosive cloud of death that we want to avoid at all costs. Don't get hit by that. It drains your health over time. I'm at full health, though. And here's an event room. What's this event? It's a pushy one. You have to push items into portals. And the portals close, thus meaning no more monsters can come out of them. I'm not a big fan of this event. It's quite difficult most of the time. Fortunately, this one is proving to be pretty simple. You can push it with spells that actually deal enough damage, or you can just push them like this. There you go! Plus 2% crit chance. Considering how often I fire with my lightning spells, that's a really good reward. So I've got increased damage. Oh! Nothing in here, just items to smash open. If you take the luck trait, I think, sometimes runes and power-ups, health will appear in those randomly. I see that there are bats here. The cultist curse here that makes them slower is actually quite good. Otherwise, you just end up chasing them forever like I am here, like a Tom and Jerry cartoon. One more! There he is! Come back here! I wish to zap you with lightning! And he got zapped. There's one more room. It's actually quite a big floor too. Okay, this room contains just things I can open. Fair enough! Down to floor 3! Floor 3 is the boss floor! On this floor, we will encounter a boss, and I hope it is a boss I can actually kill. So I'd like to demo the second areas for you. I'd like to show you what's beyond. Just one run I decided I'd do, just to show you what it's all... Oh, is that a rock I can smash? That's a rock I can smash! Wanted to show you what the game's like, because I'm enjoying it a lot. The niggling-ness with the level 3 spells and not being able to learn them very quickly is something I'm getting used to. I have a few level 3 spells that aren't too bad. I'm going to pick plus 10 max hit points, to be honest. I don't tend to pick hit points. I tasted blood. No, the stench of blood was strong enough to taste, and the air seemed to vibrate, ringing echoes through the trees.